Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. All right, we are in the Pathfinder Hall on the Nexus. Let's go talk to Tan one more time, see if he's got anything additional for us.
Logistics updates are due within the hour.
Ryder, you're off to a promising start. I meant what I said. You are a symbol now of hope that things will get better. Do I worry about this terraforming network? What do we really know about it?
It's like nothing we've ever seen. It's clear somebody had big plans for this cluster.
But who?
Not sure yet, but at least we're on the trail.
Did you have some other business?
Nope.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
My pleasure. I see great things in our future.
I mean, personally, Tan comes across as a little, distasteful, uncomfortable. I don't know how to describe it. But he's the only one that's not questioning what we're doing. We already had the Krogan. Was it Kesh? Upset that we went military. I don't know. But you can't please everybody all the time.
An expedition to Eos in the Pythia system has discovered a mystery.
Alright, there's Tan's assistant. Anything else here? No. Okay, Addison wants to talk to us, apparently. I'm sure she's gonna have wonderful things to say to us. Well, I think this is the other network we gotta scan, or short.
Choice do we have?
Nope, it's Addison.
How the hell should I know? Spender, you have a job. If you want to keep it, do it. God damn it.
Spender was the one that Drac had a problem with.
You've shaken things up, Pathfinder. My department actually has colonial affairs to direct. And you have new tools to help grow the initiative. AVP, ready for spending.
Sam said there was new functionality to discuss.
It's how the initiative was designed to support the Pathfinder. You and your team are out there making Andromeda viable. That empowers all of us. Hit a threshold. A new cryo group can be brought out. Want more security, like you chose at Prodromos? That's your call. Brekker will introduce the interface and handle minutia. All you need to do is decide what life in Andromeda means. No pressure.
Okay, speak with Addison's assistant, Brekker. Vladimir. All right, Vladimir.
Hello, Pathfinder. I am Cryo Deployment Administrator Vladimir Brekker, C-63 Galati. Your first task is to decide irrevocably the course of every life in the initiative.
irrevocably?
That seems like too much.
Yes, of course. But now you respect what we're doing. Andromeda viability and Nexus thresholds are your tools, your reward, and our future. How can I help?
Alright, you're gonna have to explain all this stuff to me.
What's the rundown on AVP?
Much of the preparation in the Milky Way was determining how to measure success. Thresholds are about capacity, but this is about cost, what we can actually afford to support. Points aren't the most elegant system, but it makes it clear. The more you earn, the more we can deploy.
Simple enough.
How are you measuring thresholds?
It's based on resource estimates and general stability, a metric of acceptable scope and risk. The more you achieve, the greater capacity we can accommodate, the more the initiative can do for you. Simplest explanation? The more you do, the more room we have to grow.
So, I decide what groups to wake up. Won't everyone be out eventually?
Absolutely. But there's an order to things. Lines of support. You can't deploy an omelet without first deploying eggs, and eggs won't get you steak. Except it's people, and how all our lives begin.
Okay, like I said, no pressure.
Alright, Brekker. Where do I start?
The interface is active and will respond only to a Pathfinder. It's ready for your first selection. You may begin shaping the initiative at your leisure.
I'm surprised that Tan is okay with this. Okay, one cryopod PTS available. So science pods, selected for their years of field experience and ingenuity under pressure, these scientists' expertise can quickly improve the initiative's research and resource gathering capabilities. Military veterans from across the Milky Way have brought their expertise to Andromeda, including advanced combat training and wilderness survival skills. Commerce pods. Trade is the lifeblood of civilization. These talented merchants and entrepreneurs can use their connections to acquire rare items, grow financial investments, or improve inventory management. Okay, I'm inclined to go science with this one, because we've got security on the Nexus seems well in hand. So we got lab and mining, munitions, hunting, okay, a lot of stuff here. Apex, tactics, commerce. So that would earn credits from investment at regular intervals, improve prices when buying and selling, and increase inventory capacity. I wouldn't mind the inventory capacity. We haven't run out yet, but I think we will eventually. Receive a drop of consumable supplies at regular intervals. Time-based. Receive organic materials at regular intervals. Okay. Receive tech materials. Receive hidden caches around established forward stations. Reveal hidden caches. Earn 50% more credits for Apex missions. See, earn research points at regular intervals and receive a selection of minerals at regular... Okay, let's do the mining operations. That's what I feel like we're lacking the most. Yep. Good to go. We can only unlock 17 of these total. So there's, what, 4 there. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, so we will get everything eventually, so it doesn't really... Commerce will probably be one of the last things I do, with the exception of maybe trade capacity. Maybe market dominance, but... Alright. Superintendent Cash reminds everyone. So that's done. Let's get... Press Y to access the viability screen. So EOS is 78% viable, apparently. Most worlds allow you to establish an outpost once you've reached 40% viability, though additional actions may be necessary. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. I want to get back to... This one, since we already started it. And we'll try to talk to whoever we can on the way. It's probably going to take us everywhere. Nothing special here. We just should stop by and talk to Ketch, see if she can scold us a little bit. Any logistics updates are due within the hour. Oh, we also got that, that murder investigation to deal with. Let's do this scan here first.
An animal did this?
Affirmative. I am able to track it.
Okay, this is standard Nexus workstation. Likely cause, sharp instrument or tool with multiple metal or bone protrusions. So we got some kind of rodent loose on here.
A correction. Is Davis. It a factual error? Pathfinder. Wow. I'm Davis Carr, Helios News Service. Maybe you've heard my voice over the vids?
No.
I'm trying to file a story right now, but hey.
HNS, huh? Where are the rest of you?
I had an editor, but it's crazy out here. Now, beyond a freelancer or two, I'm it. All that stands between freedom and tyranny. Or something. I haven't had much sleep.
Oh, you don't seem very motivated.
Who pays for you to do this?
Technically, HNS is an arm of the initiative, but we serve the public, not them. Sometimes the higher-ups try and tell us what to broadcast, TAN especially, but we decide what to run and how to run it. It causes friction, but at least I can live with myself.
Okay, well, free media is important.
Were you a journalist back in the Milky Way?
I was. Sort of. Only had a couple internships under my belt. Good places, though. The New Star Chronicle even sent me to Mars for a week. The plan was just to work as a reporter out here. Then the uprising happened. We got a little too close. My editor was killed.
Tan blamed our broadcasts for stirring unrest. It was bullshit. Now all I want to do is keep going.
Okay, did you need anything from me or what?
Talk to you later, Davis. Hey, Ryder, before you go, I hate to ask, but it seems like your job takes you all over the places we can't broadcast yet. If I send receivers to your ship, would you mind placing them on some planets? It'll help get news out to even the most far-flung colonists.
What do you need from me, exactly?
I'm digging up good stories here, but not a lot of people beyond the Nexus can hear them. Our long-distance transmitter sends package data between ships, and even planet-side, provided there's a receiver on the other end. I need someone to place receivers and boost our signal. We only have a few, so they need to go on planets with people.
Sure.
Okay, Davis. I'll help you get set up.
Great. Just place a receiver near an outpost, and they'll get our reports.
Okay, nice. What else we got?
Any logistics updates are due within the hour.
Security footage, we don't need to see that.
Hey, there's puke on the floor. I'm gonna get sick. You're sick, locking a man up with germs. If I die, I'm gonna sue your asses.
Keep blowing that hot air, pal. It'll dry out faster.
If he dies, he's gonna sue him. All right, Rinsis, we need to figure out what's going on with you.
I hear you went down to Eos. Did you find anything to help my case?
You're a liar. The Chief's Omnitool recorded you over the body admitting to killing him.
What? Wait, that's not... What are you trying to pull?
Sam, playback.
Sorry, old friend. Had to do it. I'm not dying on this rock. Well, shit. Guess my fate is sealed.
Except that your shot missed. A Ket blast to the back killed Reynolds.
Are you serious? I'm innocent? What a stroke of luck. The conviction will have to be overturned. The sentence thrown out.
Well, I mean... Yes, but that would be attempted murder. And I'm not like Judge Dredd here. I'm not the law. We'll let Tan deal with that.
Director Tan will determine what's to be done. You did try to cover it all up.
Look, I'm sorry I lied, but if my shot missed, I'm innocent, plain and simple.
We'll see about that.
Okay, speak with Tan. All right, we're gonna get back to Tan, apparently. Yeah, I mean, the guy shouldn't go free. He did try to murder somebody. Let's freaking scan this other wire. What's up, Drac?
How many times have I told you this story?
343.
Wait, what? You've been keeping count?
I want to listen to this first.
Roshan, that's not funny.
Apex personnel, please check your duty
creature.
For important updates.
It's huge.
Pathfinder, I believe you found the culprit responsible for the power shortages.
Well, I have a rule here on Earth that, for myself anyways, I shouldn't say here on Earth, but once a bug becomes too big, I can't just kill it. Not because I can't step on it, I can kill it, but, you know, once it becomes too juicy. We'll try to capture this giant thing, because who knows what it is. How this thing is able to walk around and no one saw it is beyond me.
Alert Professor Herrick to come secure it.
All right, got another level up. What's going on, Drac? I think we already read this, haven't we? Oh, just in case. For posterity, in the case the initiative goes belly up, the Nexus is a four-ring circus. Don't like how Tan operates, and his disdain for the Krogan is obvious. I believe his intentions are ultimately good, but he's an opportunist who's likely to create dissent. I don't see the Nexus coming together if he's left unchecked. It's already polarizing. Addison, she's taking the cue to circle the wagons. I think I can talk to Kandros about this and at least try to get the two of us more coordinated. Or maybe not. Seriously hate this kind of drama.
Pathfinder, thanks for helping Raj and Zara find Atkins. He's not getting out of lockup for a while.
Ryder, can you believe this place?
One space station slightly dented?
You should have seen it a year ago. It was more than just dented. Anyway, thanks for bringing me on. Tan can't kick me off the station now, and it's been nice seeing my granddaughter again.
The two of you seem close.
It's been Kesh and me against the galaxy the moment I got her. Well, maybe not as much now, but it sure was early on.
Because that little twitch he does is a little weird. Do you have unused research data? Yeah, okay.
Superintendent Macmore, I have some reports here that...
Oh, sorry, comms breaking down. Probably wiring. Try again later?
What?
How can we be out of those materials?
I don't know. Ben's looking into it. Don't worry, probably just another computer glitch.
Vetra never had these glitches.
That's because Vetra kept it all in her head. We mere mortals aren't as good at that.
Good job on the outpost. Maybe Addison will lighten up.
What do you mean?
She's been pretty upset about not having an initiative outpost established yet. Understandable, if you ask me. I'm just glad she's got work to focus on now.
Okay, looks like we got nothing new here.
Nothing more for now.
Good luck out there.
Okay, she's not going to lecture me about my whole military outpost. Okay, Tan, we got to head back to his ass. Let's see. I missed my jump jet. Oh, I forgot about you. What can I do for you?
Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tavessa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer. I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tans asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
Nice to see someone so devoted to her work.
That's kind. Sometimes the camera makes people shy away from me.
That's a shame.
So that's what I need. The truth, I mean. Someone needs to record the history we're making.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like propaganda. Though I also don't think you should intentionally try to scare people. Fear-mongering is bad. But let's give her the benefit of the doubt.
It takes integrity to record the truth and nothing but.
Well, I do my best. And you could help me out. The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
You don't mind treading on the initiative director's toes?
What would he do? Pull funding we don't have? I'm game if you are.
Sure.
Okay, interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
Let's see, our leadership describes this as anticipated issues. Would you agree? Well, I mean, yeah, if you... Well, we do need to do better, but at the same time, you just travel to a new galaxy. I don't know. I'm more on the positive side.
All expeditions have to deal with supplies, enemies, or hell, just getting lost. We'll deal with all of them. We just need time.
Tan will love that. But if that's your take, that's what goes in. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. This was more fun than I expected. You were great. I'll get to work editing.
Okay, on hold. Wait for Carrie's next interview to slot. Interview slot. Gotcha. All right, Tan. You need to solve this murder. Is that something sparking? I'm going to get that fixed. There's a plant right in front of it. Could be a fire or something. Unless it's a fake plant, but still cause a fire, I guess.
Something I can help you with?
Director, I checked out that murder. Nilken didn't do it, but there's proof that he meant to.
This is unfortunate. We're trying to give the people a sense of stability, leadership they think they can count on. And we're setting precedent for justice here in Andromeda. Now this, a convicted murderer who didn't commit the murder.
These things are almost never black and white.
I know. If we suppress the evidence and uphold the conviction, we're banishing a man for a crime he technically didn't commit. If we throw the conviction out, we're freeing a man who tried to take matters into his own hands, then covered it up. Your investigation complicated this. You should take responsibility for the outcome.
You're a dick.
Do we still exile him for murder?
Well, look, I don't like the two options here. But I'm not about to set up a corrupt judicial system. And the guy didn't do it. The option to retry him on a lesser charge should exist. But it doesn't, so we're going to release him.
It was crazy down there. Life and death. But his shot didn't kill Reynolds. We have to let him go.
You're a bottom line type of person. I hope we don't regret it. All right, so be it. He will do community service for his role in the chaos. But he's a free man. Well, at least we'll have this sordid business behind us.
Sure, that's going to bite me in the ass at some point. We'll see. All right, what else do we want to do? Got a lot of crap here. Whoops. Okay, we've crafted the Pathfinder chess piece. I don't care about that. We can do that. Okay, data trail. Follow the nav point. Okay, we haven't done that yet. That's back on EOS. That we're a little behind on, but... Okay, we meet Carrie's good. Locate the researchers' other stations. Okay, so that's a EOS one. Travel to wildlife. Search for supplies in the Hyperium Atrium. Interesting. Okay, that's on Eos, and that's going to be on the planets. Can't do anything with the arcs. Find Spender on the Nexus. By all accounts, William Spender is a difficult man, but there is a reason to suspect that the Assistant Director of Colonial Affairs is actively working to undermine the Krogan. Drak has asked to investigate Spender's activities. Okay. Let's do that one. Let's go SAM node. I think we've got two things to accomplish there. Yeah. So we need to see our sister, speak with Sam about the unlocked memory and the memory trigger. Okay, memory triggers we have to find on planets. What is it telling me is up here?
Any logistics updates are due within the hour.
I think it's just telling us the pathways underneath us, the tram. Let's go see if our strike teams are done.
The suspect's in custody.
Supplier.
Nope. They got
request is in.
A lot of time left.
Ammo today. Focus on melee.
Could see this guy should be out of jail already. His wife's not there either. So no thanks from her. Yep, he's out. Alright, we'll see how that turns out for us. Okay, let's go to the cryo deck first, see our sister and whatever else is there. We've just released some new people, so.
HNS, your source for news in Helios, an independent arm of the Andromeda Initiative.
Okay, that's, never mind, that's back at the other way.
When we arrived,
we hit an energy cloud. They're calling it the Scourge.
Wow, that doesn't sound scary.
The Nexus got it worse. As long as you avoid it, things seem to be okay.
Yeah, just don't run into it.
Good. I'll make it right, Dash. I promise. Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you. It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus. I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were gonna start families out here together. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
Okay, next time we go to Eos, we'll be able to handle that.
Oi, Pathfinder. Today has not been a good day.
Oi.
Why is that?
A large shipment of medical supplies intended for Prodromus was intercepted by those damned exiles. Scouts confirmed they've divvied the supplies up among their own outposts.
Hmm.
I'll see what I can do about reclaiming them.
That would be great. Thanks. Maybe when you come across them assholes, you can rectify all this.
I mean, maybe we can pull the exiles back into the fold. That would be the best resolution.
Lots of reasons. Terrible luck with women.
Harry, what's happening with Sarah?
Well, we got her out of the pod. I don't want to get your hopes up, but Sam managed to, find her, you might say.
I don't follow.
Well, she's still in a coma. But she also has an implant like yours, and Sam managed to access it. He's made contact.
That's incredible. She's okay.
Vitals are steady, but I'm letting Sam take the lead on this one.
Though in a coma, Sarah's mental processes remain intact.
So, is she okay?
You can ask her yourself. A moment while I establish a link with her implant. Proceed.
Sarah? Can you hear me?
Is that you, little brother? What's happening? Where am I?
There was a problem with your stasis pod. You're in a coma on the Hyperion. Do you understand?
I think so. Am I dreaming?
Sam linked into your implant, but they say you're stable. You're safe and sound in the medbay.
This is so weird. I hear you, but I can't feel anything. Where's Dad? Is he doing okay?
How about we let her get out of her coma before we... Yeah, I'm gonna lie to her. Because I don't know if she's gonna be able to... How clearly she can think while her coma, but let's not let her dwell on the death of her father while she's unconscious.
He's away on a mission right now. I know he's worried about you, though.
Yeah, I know Dad. He probably said, she'll live, and went off to go study some new form of algae.
It wasn't like that. He cares.
How many times has he yelled at you so far?
Oh, the usual.
Well, when he gets back, tell him he needs to stop picking on my little brother. What's home like? Is Habitat 7 as beautiful as they promised?
This I'll be honest about.
There's been some... complications. The Golden Worlds didn't exactly deliver.
Damn. Well, we knew it could get rough. Dad will find us a place to live.
Yeah. I'm sure he will.
And I should be there helping you guys do it.
Well, you were never one to quit, Sarah. A little nap won't hold you back.
Hell no, it won't. As soon as I'm up, I'm helping you and Dad find home.
You got it.
And then...
What happened?
The connection was only temporary. Her condition remained stable.
Well, so we just hung up on her, huh?
Sorry, it seemed better than nothing. I'll keep you posted, promise.
Thanks, Harry.
Ryder, that was a hell of a thing talking to your sister in a coma. Can't say I really bought into the whole Sam implant, but, well, that was pretty amazing.
It was kind of weird.
I don't know. The whole thing was strange.
I know what you mean, but everything seems weird at first. There was a time when my profession thought germs were a crazy idea. Just takes getting used to. And if it can help my patients, I'll keep an open mind.
So you and Lexi swapped jobs?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by. So it made sense that Lexi and I switched places. She's younger. Well, for Asari, they're still teenagers when they're 200. And she's one hell of a doctor. She'll serve the Tempest well.
He almost sounds like maybe the same voice actor that did the voice of the Drell in Mass Effect 2. Thane. Just a little, and it might not be the same guy, because Thane's voice was obviously modulated in some way, but...
We'll miss you, Harry.
Just make sure to raise some hell once in a while, will you? I'm living vicariously through you.
Deal. How's Sarah doing?
Everything seems fine. Hearing your voice had to help. Even if you did bend the truth there.
Yeah, why don't you mind your own damn business, Doctor? How about that?
How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
All right, Doc, it was good talking to you. Maybe get that shoulder twitch looked at
That's
before
all
I come back.
Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
All right, that's all good to go. And I guess that's all good to go. Nothing really to check. All right, so now we need to head to Sam Node, which I think is a different part of the ship. I need to do something about my red pants. I don't really like them that well.
Convicted murderer Nilkin Rensis, pardoned after an investigation by the human Pathfinder, proved his innocence. This is HNS.
Well, the guy went into a lot of detail in his report, and I went to the wrong place. Or did I? Yeah, I did. Where did I go to? I went back to operations.
Authorities continue work to establish contact with our Milky Way descendants. As of now, beacons confirming arrival in Helios remain unanswered. This is HNS.
So it looks like HNS just does headlines. It's pretty much, he just reads a headline. No details. Or investigations of any kind. Just a headline. Angry woman.
It's you.
Yes, please.
You, Pathfinder. I have a word or two for you.
Is there a problem?
Your father is my problem. He's everyone's problem. We're all paying for Alec Ryder's ego. He preyed on Jean Garson's trusting nature and bulldozed us to this godforsaken place. Now she's dead, and we'll all soon follow.
Hey, my dad died for this dream. He was trying to fix things for all of us.
Some dream. He fixed us all right. Go to hell, Pathfinder.
Well, why don't you go fuck yourself? I'll fight you right now. I'm just kidding. Let's get out of here. Alright, nothing in here. Okay, let's check out, let's go to that terminal, our father's room first.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
I think we already heard that.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Another eidetic trigger, Sam?
One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnode on the Hyperion to investigate further. Your father's personal logs.
Okay, it looks like they're still encrypted. Alright, so that'll be done later. Let's go to the Samnode and we can get... unlock those memories. Nothing over there.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories, which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay. Something new every day. Dr. Arbordana at the tech lab sent some equations for you to solve.
I'm ready.
Transferring them now. Have fun. Hey, what the? Sam!
Malicious code detected. Please.
Sam?
Attempting to countermand malicious code. Please stand by.
That bitch.
Is there anything I can do? Sam! Is that another malfunction, or... Sam, you trying to show me something?
Okay, reset panel.
Wait, wrong order.
Okay. Where does he start at? There. There, okay.
Okay, I think I got it. Okay, I think I got it. Sam, talk to me!
Hello, Pathfinder. Please initialize the console to restore normal operations.
Well, that's not cool.
Sam, what happened?
The equations contained a Trojan horse program, a virus, specifically targeted to sever our connection and render me helpless. Reconnecting would be impossible.
How do you feel? Are you okay?
I cannot feel pain. However, I would avoid repeating the experience. Which is the purpose of pain in organic life.
Unlock the door. Let's head to the tech lab and see what Dr. Arbordana has to say.
All right, let's do this memory thing first, though.
One of your father's memories is available.
Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied. Alec?
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
Wow. Hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
I would hope so. Mom's life was worth fighting for.
It would seem his obstinance extended to me as well.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it.
We've gotten at least three of those locations, but maybe that just unlocked audio logs.
I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. However, using quantum entanglement...
Okay, we already knew that.
I remain in constant touch with
you. I'm just going to gray these out, but we've already heard them.
This raw data...
Then Dad, at...
You removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Me more than you.
This one may be new.
Do you know anything more about Sarah's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlyle's reports. He is providing her with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
What did you mean by
a flower? In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis. Each exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was...
So there are other...
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced Sam in the initiative.
Okay.
That's all for now.
Of course.
Yeah, I just wanted to get all those grayed out so I know what's new and what's not.
Your father's personal logs.
So we found three of the memories, but we only got to play one. I'll have to go back in there and see if we get more.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
I guess that's it.
Welcome back, Ryder.
Okay, guess we don't have any memories.
Of course.
That's weird. So maybe one memory trigger doesn't automatically equate to a memory, though. Okay, we need to go find that doctor who tried to screw us over. Let's go ahead and do that. She was back at the cultural center area. Okay, we're done with that. Where is it? That one.
Residents are still mourning the loss of Jean Garson. The initiative founder was killed when the Nexus hit the Scourge. An official tribute is planned, though Director Jaren Tan has provided a few details so far.
Without Jean, we wouldn't be here. But now that we are here, we need to focus on surviving before we can celebrate.
This is HNS.
I still don't believe Jean Garson's dead. So we'll see. Alright, doctor. Once we get more
biomaterial. Welcome, Pathfinder. Did Sam solve the equations I sent?
Solve them? They almost brought down Samnode.
The equations contained a virus designed to target artificial intelligence.
You think I... Never! I abhor violence against any life, organic or synthetic.
Then how did the virus find its way into your equations?
Perhaps my files were altered or replaced. But why?
I've seen a lot of down with AI sentiment lately. Graffiti, complaints to 10. Perhaps someone took the next step.
Okay, what's wrong with AI? That's an obvious answer to it, but I guess we'll go ahead and ask it anyways.
Why would anyone hate artificial intelligence?
Synthetic life has different needs and motivations. It can be mysterious and powerful. Many fear what is not understood.
Everything's uncertain. Maybe they just want to feel safer.
Attacking Sam is bold, though. I wonder if there have been similar incidents.
The AI kiosk was busted this morning.
I can look around.
Pathfinder Rider, if you will.
What do you need? What else do you need?
Pathfinder, we've had some trouble.
Anything I can help with?
Perhaps. I discharged an away team to get readings from a section of the Scourge that was behaving anomalously. They haven't reported in for some time, and sensors can't locate their shuttle. I sent them out there. Good, dedicated people. I fear what might have happened to them.
Don't give up hope. When I'm out there, I'll see if I can find them.
Their friends and family will want to know what's happened, and I need to know.
All right, quests all over the place. I guess we will do the Firefighter's quest. We'll finish that up in the next episode. And I'm not sure how much longer we'll be here. Probably at least another episode's worth. I probably won't do all the side tasks, so maybe I'll just finish up the Firefighters and then we'll head off. Maybe back to Eos, clean up some of that area. Might not be a bad idea. But okay, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I know you have a choice in where you watch your Mass Effect Let's Plays, and I thank you for choosing One Night Sniper. Peace out, everyone.